Modern Mail Radio with Jared Zavistowski, right here on LA Talk Radio.
What's up, everybody? I'm your host, Jared Zavistowski, and you're listening and watching Modern Mail Radio. This is all the stuff your mama should have told you and the stuff your daddy never knew. And joining me tonight, as always, my co-host, Sarah Chapman.
Hi!
Hey there.
How's everybody doing tonight? We got a full house. I love it when it's full.
Yes, you do.
We've got Canadian girl and matchmaker Sandy DePaz. Did I say it right?
Oh, absolutely.
Because sometimes I don't say it right, and then I'm just like, how do you say your name?
You know what? We practiced in the parking lot. Perfect.
Actually, it was more like, what's your Instagram, bitch? Because I don't know who you are. But it's good enough, right?
Oh, absolutely. Perfection.
Glad to have you here.
Thank you.
And my girl, Minnie Scarlett,
hey.
Who's a model and actress. I'm so glad she's actually here. I haven't seen her in a couple years. This is like a reunion. Very special for me
tonight. It's been like 2 years, I think.
Yeah, it's been 2 years. My time frame is that. Was I blonde? Was I brunette?
It's like short, super
white
blonde.
Was I taking pictures of you? Were you taking pictures of me? That sounds kind of
kinky. Blur.
Yeah. It was a blur. But I'm so happy to have you here.
Yes, it's great to have
me
you.
Too.
Yeah.
And for the last like year and a half, I think I've been booking guests exclusively. Like I just had everything all set up, and then Sarah came on, and
I just messed it up, Jared.
Let's be honest. When you hopped on, and we went off the rails a few times. But
I hopped on, and we went off the rails. There's been a learning curve.
But the show is still going strong, and it's good to have some of your guests, some of your network on.
Some of them not so good, but thank you, because tonight's good.
Actually, who was it? It was James on the last show. I thought he was great.
James was good. Yeah really
that was
good.
Your guest, and great. He had a lot to contribute and add, so I hope that you got some big shoes to fill, girl. And I mean that both metaphorically and literally.
No,
he was a big
she
man.
She might have some big sharks to punch because he was Australian and went on about that. And
just diving into
sharks.
The water.
Yeah.
Diving into the water, punching sharks and handling snakes.
I think she's safe. Safe.
Safe.
You know, my safe. Favorite word to say in an Australian accent is woodluff.
What even woodluff. Is that?
It's wildlife.
Jeez, I'm learning
woodluff?
Something new. I should know
like
this.
Like woodluff.
My favorite word is dick. No, because you say
can
dick
you
and dick at the same time, like they sound like the same word. So you say dick and
it's
dick.
True.
I love it when women polish my dick. Y'all get some wood polish out there. Yeah. You guys ever see that YouTube video? Oh my god, it's the greatest thing ever. Like you have to go.
That took me a second actually.
Yeah.
I was like, what?
It took him a second too.
Because the E's are pronounced
was.
Under, so if it's dick, dick, they're the same word.
It's true.
I love it when people wash my dick.
As long as you can figure out how to cork it properly.
Yeah, you have to cork it too.
Just make sure you know what to do with the cork.
Yeah. Oh, man. All right.
Mom.
I didn't practice my Australian accent today. I was practicing my American accent.
I practiced my vile pornographic accent.
You're doing good. I mean, but at some point it does come out. Like I've heard you a little bit tonight, and all of a sudden it's like, oh, there it is.
I've heard a little Canada.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I noticed it.
I'm a border city girl, right? So I got the blend, you know, a little bit of Canadian American on the side.
No wonder you have Jared's book sitting in front
I love
of
how,
you.
Oh!
Uh-oh!
I love how everybody thinks that an American accent's got a twang to it. They're like, oh, yeah, we're going to go down here and get some John Wayne in us. This is going to be epic. It's like, we don't
That's fairly hillbilly.
There's like nobody that talks like that except for a very, very, very small percentage of like people that live in Louisiana. Like
it's
that Duck Dynasty people don't. Well, yeah. They're
it's
like
a Walmart Route 66 or Sears kind of pocket.
Yeah, am I going there? Am I get my duck collar? I'm going to go eat some snakes.
Definitely a denim pocket.
Eat some beans. Now
so
I'm just going.
I was thinking Jared's beans. Book was more like.
Oh, that's a loaded.
Contempora decor in my house.
I haven't actually seen this.
It's very much a coffee table book.
Oh, absolutely.
So Minnie's a modern male virgin. So we are definitely popping her modern male cherry right now.
Oh.
She's ooh. Like, I don't even know what show I'm on right now, guys. But I'm here.
I didn't see this IRL. I saw it on the internet.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I was giving.
Wait, IRL. Did you just go in real life abbreviated right then? Props to that.
Oh. I thought you said URL. URL. I was like, what?
Yeah.
Wait, what? What URL? There's a URL in the back, but I'm like, was it really that noticeable? Jesus. No, look. There's pictures.
Oh my goodness.
There we go. Perfect.
Wow, it's just like the internet.
You can color them too.
Just like third grade.
It's amazing. There's pictures everywhere, guys. Okay.
So poor redheaded stepchild.
Oh, by the way,
that's the three words I read.
So I was lonely the past couple days.
How ironic, right?
Yeah.
For your
show. Were you lonely?
Aww. I was kind of lonely.
So lonely girl.
I brought your book with me, and I was taking pictures in my
My book. I saw that.
Yeah, wow. In my hometown city, giving you some loving. You were giving me some loving back. It was really reciprocated.
So that's a first.
And I was sharing it on my flight here, too.
Be rubbing on it, touching it inappropriately.
Okay, so how were the responses from the people sitting next to you on the plane when you're like, yo, I think we're going to have a chat?
Okay, are we talking females or males?
I don't know. Who were you sitting next to, and what were you sharing with them?
All right. So, first of all, I'm like a Care Bear. I don't know how to explain.
So you share, or you stare, or
I don't share and stare. I'm like magnetic force, man. Everywhere I go, I attract people. So I'm on the airport, at the airport, Toronto Airport, and I'm just waiting for my flight. So I have this gentleman next to me. He's like, so what do you do? Where are you going? So I tell him, curiosity.
You're like, no, I will not give you a blowjob. Knock
He's being all respectful.
Right, right.
So I get on my flight. Right. I have an empty seat next to me now. So he knows where I'm sitting. Mm-hmm. So he comes next to me. He's like, can I have your business card? I'm like, sure. And I'm like,
no, you cannot have my vagina. Done. Like, seriously.
And I'm like so into his book.
Strike two.
So I'm a big fan of multitasking. So I'm reading your book. But at the same time, I barely watch TV or movies. And I'm watching Magic Mike, what, the second version or what it, what's
yeah,
it called?
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know. Is Channing Tatum dancing around?
So I got Magic Mike, Hot Men on my screen, and then Jared's book. And then he wants my business card. And I'm like, yeah, that's how it's done.
okay.
Nice.
So it was like a trap, basically.
So do you attribute you're getting that guy to my book? Because I don't think that that's the case.
No, that's a good case.
What were you wearing?
Ooh.
That's a good question, right? It's fair.
She's
like, I was wearing a turtleneck.
Oh, absolutely not. I'm always dressed slassy, like, you know, sassy, right. Sexy, classy, and elegant.
I thought you just said slassy, and I was like, are we about to coin a new one? Slutty and classy.
Maybe. I like that. I like that.
I like that, too.
I like that, too.
Slassy.
No, I identify with that.
Done.
All right. You know what?
I'm retiring. Hashtag slassy.
We're trademarking that. We're trademarking that right now.
You can do that.
All right. Okay, she's like, we. I'm like, no, me.
Unfortunately. You want it to go viral, so trademark is probably not the best thing to do. Yeah, however, you can trademark. It's about $400 depending.
We'll negotiate.
That just got way too like businessy for me. I'm just over here in the slass mode.
Speaking of business, you brought an entire page of statistics, which is
like writing
amazing
on paper.
I'm curious.
But first, before we get like too far into this like rabbit hole of awesomeness,
do you lift?
Do you fucking lift? No. I gotta ask you one question. Kidding. Let's tell people what you do. You're a matchmaker, and you became a matchmaker because you were an FBI profiler or a police profiler.
Just another day.
Right?
Because that's usual.
Just another day. But you know what? I like the American version of that. Like, FBI. That just sounds like, ooh.
It just sounds cool.
He has no idea what he's talking about. That's why that version just came out.
Wait, am I completely off? What is it?
No, you're completely off. Just the Canadian version isn't classified as FBI. But, so my background, I went for school. My background is policing, and I did investigations and... You know, at times I do still get called. I freelance, so I do.
So you free handcuff? Like you have to like go and like
wait,
arrest
so like,
people?
Wait. Because
no, freelance.
Go back to the FBI thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're a freelance. What are you, an investigator? Or are you like a? Like,
into
how
that.
Does this work? Come on.
Oh my goodness. So the American, the Canadian version is completely different. I don't want to waste airtime on that. But I am still doing PI here and there.
Okay.
Depending on, of course, because I'm all about effective time management.
Mm-hmm.
Private are the investigations?
Ooh, you select your own task.
Okay.
When you're a freelancer.
All right.
So
is that like trolling Craigslist? You're like, yeah, that one I'm gonna have to take.
No. It varies. You could go on set at NBC Studios, and then there could be a situation there, and you're being an undercover actor.
Cool.
Or
you know, I'm just totally talking shit, by the way. So.
Yeah. That's where I utilize all my skills and talents is from my law enforcement background into my matchmaking. So that's where I got my gut feeling, my intuition. So I'm very good at reading people inside and out. So I can.
What about wrangling them though? Like when they really need it, you're like, dude, you're doing it wrong. Like, come on.
But you know what? I could.
Like, do you use tough love? Like, this is kind of where I'm going with this.
No, I do. I am very direct. I'm very selective. Mm-hmm. I am a perfectionist in everything I do. Why? Because I'm passionate, but also I want to make sure that I have the right type of clientele. Because if I don't have that connection, that trust,
mm-hmm.
it's not going to be effective service.
So passion and purpose, and then
So
success.
It's a lot of profiling. I do get hate mail, but that's all good because it filters it out very, very quickly.
I heard Canada.
Yeah, that was Canada. Out.
Hey. As far as I'm concerned,
we're trapping her to the accent.
She gets you to talk in the mic a little more. There we go.
The more hate mail you get, the more you're closer to achieving success. Like I said, I am very selective with all my clients. If I don't feel there's any trusting relationship in between my client and myself.
So wait, back it up. Because you went straight from profiling into matchmaking. So, but you didn't tell us that you were going to do that. So it just went, you just started talking about the other one. So you were a profiler professionally full time, and then you started doing part time. You still do part time freelance work. And undercover work? That's
for
the police department, or is this for like just privatized? Is it private?
Yeah, everything is.
It's private and it's undercovers.
She pegged it on.
I feel a sitcom coming on here.
We got our own sitcom.
Minnie's gonna be definitely like the odd chick out again, because in the one that she's doing, she's like. Not, she doesn't really fit, right? You don't fit.
In the web series that I am doing right now, I basically am like the little sister that kind of just doesn't fit in, and it's for obvious reasons. Everyone else is like not Asian. I'm the Asian one, so it's kind of strange, but then obviously we never actually address that, and that's part of like the comedy of it.
So. And in our hypothetical new one, the handcuffs aren't going to fit because you're so freaking small. So basically,
I could run away.
Yeah, you could get out of the situation every time she tries to take you down in this private undercover hypothetical situation.
Yeah.
It's going to make us a shit ton of money.
Technically, we're the odd ones out because she's the only one that actually has a boyfriend.
That is actually
or
true.
Or has a significant other.
Did
we're
you
all
have
single.
To remind me of this? God, my life just got so much more pathetic. Again, all I have is you, water. That's all I have.
Your work husband. It's so good.
I even
water, cough, cough.
Sarah is married to beer.
I even gave up social media because I was like, done with you.
Are you detoxing now? Social media?
Super detoxing
no,
from
don't
social
detox.
Media.
Because I'm going to go through withdrawals next. I just met in the parking
when
lot.
When she asked me to take a selfie, I was like, what's that? I was like, what? It's been like 5 days. I have no idea what you're even saying to me.
Okay, that's unacceptable because I feel a connection between us.
Like, it happened anyway. Like, I let you take this, like, thing and put it here, and I was like, okay. Just let it happen, Sarah. Just let it happen. And it did. And I kind of looked cute.
It's like photographic rape.
I was asking her. Yeah, it was a little rapey.
It's like, I'm going to take that shit, bitch.
It was a little rapey.
You're getting this selfie.
But I sort of felt that there was like an undercover investigation going on for this. So I felt like I had to go with it. Otherwise, I was going to get detained for a video.
Oh.
Or a Snapchat. I'm glad we just left it at selfie.
Yeah.
Am I on Instagram right now? What's going on with that?
No.
Yeah.
Okay. So back to what you did, how those two transitions fascinates me. What led to the jump from PI work into date
matchmaking?
Coaching? Matchmaking. But I mean, you're a coach and you're a matchmaker. So you not only do you help set these people up, but you give them tips and pointers so that they can succeed with their significant. Hopeful, right?
Or
I mean,
so they
have they ever met him? Or
like
blind
properly?
Dates?
Properly, like,
have I?
So you like set up the blind date, and then you kind of coach both of them so they succeed?
Yeah, absolutely.
Interesting.
Right on. Yeah. So it's from beginning right to end, but it's very hands on. So,
how hands on? It's just like
it's hands on.
Very tactical.
Baby. Oh, very tactical.
Okay.
Hands on. From beginning to end, even right before they go on their date, I make sure I give them a prep rally. So I call them, and I want a selfie picture. To make sure.
Why didn't I doubt that? Right away.
And I'll check your ID.
Doesn't
too.
Matter how the lighting is. Let's just get this shit over with.
Yeah, exactly. Because I want to ensure, like I said, that everybody's legit. They are who they are.
Selfies are in the new fingerprints, right?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
okay.
I think so. But yeah.
Not so. Back to catfishing, which we'll get to shortly.
True.
Yeah.
There's a lot of weird shit out there.
Catfish.
Yeah. The digital world has made it completely. It's completely possible to adopt a person's identity and use their pictures and photos. And if you stalk them well enough, actually convince people that you're them. And I've seen this before. And it's absolutely insane. We're gonna be talking about some statistics here in a second.
We
guys.
Are, because she wrote a ton of stuff
oh
down.
Look at this.
But wait, for a second, have you guys seen the new app
page.
Where it's
one
like
page.
Video and you can like put a face of a celeb on yours? Am I like
what?
The last person to see mm-mm. this? Because I saw this yesterday.
I have no idea what
you can like
about.
Morph your own face with a celebrity's face and do it on video and then pretend to be them.
That's creepy.
It's the creepiest
yeah,
thing
shit.
I've ever seen, Dane Cook. Thank you so much for doing that.
Was it Dane Cook?
Yeah, but I don't want to bring him up because he Tinder matched me and then unmatched me. So,
ooh.
Done with him.
Oh, he unmatched you?
Well,
Fuck you, Dave.
You done cost me.
I actually love that guy. I think he's great.
Cost me a whole week of communication.
I was in your corner when you matched Dane Cook. I was like, yes, go get him, Sarah. I was all for it. I was cheering in the background. I'm like, yeah.
Kind of shot myself in the foot on that one. But you know what? I'm better off for it.
But then you guys had met before at a bar.
Yeah,
and
one
he,
time
like,
we
used
did.
You as a trash.
Like, are we still talking about this asshole? He's done. He's cut.
Okay, so yeah. Back to you and FBI profiling and day coaching.
And so, using a pen on lined paper.
Oh my, I am so old school.
Like, it's great.
Let's talk about the process because yes. I want to get to know exactly what it is. Like, how does it work? So if I come up to you and I'm like, hey, I want a girl. Do you actually break down like into the, you know, the infinitesimal specificity of what I want, how I am? And then you're reading the whole person the whole time.
Absolutely.
So you're kind of seeing what they're saying and what they really want, and, you know, reading through the lines. And then you're actually going, hey, do you have like a roster of chicks? Do you have like a chick?
Justin Bieber's playing in the background. What do you mean?
Like a whole diet.
She's got
like a chick catalog.
Got a Bic pen. She's just like.
Yeah. So basically, my clients will reach out to me. They'll inquire the service. And between that, we talk on the phone. We do pre-screening. And then from there, I meet with them one-on-one. Because on the phone, it's hard to determine who exactly are they. Are they my competitor? Who are they? Right.
So you don't FaceTime them or Skype them or any of that
no,
stuff?
No. It's just on the phone. And then in person. Because when you're in person, your body language just speaks volumes.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm. So does your odor. If it's offensive, you can just go. Like, you're already done.
Totally. But, like, when you meet with somebody in person, like tonight, like I met you for the first time, right?
How do I smell?
Oh, my goodness. You smell fabulous.
All right. We're good.
And you look great.
That was so DeAndre. I love her. Ah!
But also, like, your tone of voice, your energy, right?
Yes.
Just meeting somebody in person, there's so many factors that comes into play. So by then, just by meeting you, and we didn't even have an in-depth conversation, what you're looking for, I could just sense.
Do you ever fuck with people? Do you ever, like, sit down and kind of, like, try and purposely creep them out or unnerve them to see how their reaction to stress is?
Because
that would be really
interesting. Because Jared does that never.
I do that to everybody. Like, the second I get to know you, and I'm like, oh, well, this engagement's boring. I'm like, poke. Let's see how you react to stress.
No.
I'm not touching you.
No, but, like, the energy, right? The energy is very strong when you meet with somebody in person. Because by, like, me and you, by texting, how we're communicating, there's so much miscommunication that's not represented properly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But in person, like, you really get a true sense who they are. And by then, I'll determine if I want to take them on as a client.
Wait, were you that person on my Instagram that told me everything I did and said was ass backwards? Was that you?
Love her.
I think we got into a domestic.
Really? Yes. Wait, a domestic Instagram dispute?
Oh, yes, we did. But then he tried to clarify it and straighten it out. And I'm like, all right. So then we bumped up to Facebook.
Oh.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And were the Instagram authorities or like the Facebook blockers called in on any of this? I hate social media right now. I'm not going to lie.
I was talking about haters really today with actually our last guest on the show. We had a meeting today and we were talking about social media and like haters and like, you know, the more haters you have, the better you're doing that whole thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But it was interesting. I was like, yeah, I'm excellent at turning haters into fans. It's like a fucking talent. I'm like, haha, you hate this?
Yep. You're doing
it
right.
Well, it's motivation, right? Because whenever you have haters or any sense of jealousy, you're succeeding. Why?
Negative press is still press.
Exactly. Because they don't have the courage, right? They never follow their dream.
Well, see, I realized very, very quickly that people hate this. They hate the outside of this book because it represents
an
ideology.
You're
going
to hate me, but you're never going to forget me.
Maybe.
So it's on one end of the spectrum or the other.
On the outside of this book, this represents like it represents an ideology that maybe not a lot of people want to get on board with.
That guy kind
of
looks like
but
Scotty.
When you open the book, then they're like, oh, I opened it the same page. No, it's not the same page. When people actually read the book, they love it. They're like, oh, my God, this is the best book I've ever read on dating.
That was actually really funny.
So we're actually taking the cover off. We're removing me from the branding because it's getting in the way. People are like, I would look at that book and be like, oh, that's douchebag. Oh, fuck that guy.
But hold on. Let's go back to Sandy's comment.
All right.
About what?
She said it's almost like an adult coloring book. You could just get some crayons.
There's some crayons
with it.
There's some diagrams here, one on one. I'm like, I could color these pictures.
Right?
Yeah.
I could make those.
And then there's
a little
big
rosier.
Print, like it's a child's book. Okay. But you know what? I will admit
We included all those things very specifically
for marketing.
It was a big, bold, bright, condescending bitch slap, and
people
works.
Need that. That is actually true.
So yeah, we made it that way because it was representative of kind of like the idiocy of the concepts that had to be relayed, like the fact that anybody would even need to hear this,
yeah,
means that you need the big bold buzz letters and maybe some coloring.
Yep.
Actually, the reason that the illustrations aren't colored is because it made the book twice as expensive to
yeah,
print.
Yeah, it's really expensive. And
so
to
I was like,
make crayons
fuck that.
With it, it's going to be really expensive too. Okay.
So anyways.
Right? You could sell just like that. A mini pack. But Minnie's going to brand it.
I will admit,
it's done
yeah.
It's a collab package right what? Now. Mini branded crayons. They're going to be real small.
Oh, yeah. Stocking stuffers for Christmas.
I know.
And
I know. It would take up the whole
time
stocking.
Only,
but yeah.
We can put this on Home Shopping Network and I can tell you about the crayons.
But let
they're
me
so
tell
small,
you.
Like, so cute.
So, Jared, you look fabulous in this photo.
Thank you.
So
compliments to DeAndre Michael. He was a photographer.
Up. And that, and it's easy to, it's easy to read, and it's very direct. Like, I could read this within, like, 3 hours.
It was made for males, and it was made for people that don't want to read. So we put
but
pictures in there,
I'm a
big, bold
too.
Letters.
That's saying a lot.
I wouldn't say it's just directly towards males. But
We made it for males, and all of the visually eye-appealing, chunked-down, very direct bullet points that we make. But then that whole book is a collection of experiences that collection of things that I learned from my experiences with women. So basically, that book is like, you know, a shit ton of women all came together and wrote this book.
It is law.
And it's being interpreted by a male.
Jared's law.
It's law.
It's called the methodology, which is another word for law. Actually, it's another word for method or process. It's like the way
well
of.
Done.
Or bullshit, depending on how mad you are at Jared.
So compliments to you. First of all, great marketing, sexy photo.
Thank you.
It is. It's
classy,
amazing.
Elegant, handsome.
An amazing piece of literature.
Very easy to read. Very direct. Very bold.
You are an excellent promotionist.
Yes. Because I'm like that, right? It's about effective time management. In your book, you just get right. You're raw. First time meeting you in person is very genuine.
Yeah, it's the same thing. What you see
exactly.
is definitely what you get slapped in the face with.
Totally. And I find when you read books,
not apologizing either.
I find when you read books it's mumbo jumbo, but you are who you are genuine. And by meeting you in person, it really reflects and compliments
thank you.
That. Like precisely, right on the tee.
No, and it's so, funny because we were, I debated over that. I mean, writing that book took about 9 months because of all of these different little marketing and branding things. We went back and forth on all these different little things, like how do we write this? How do we do this? And I'm actually a great writer, and I have the ability to write in very, very complex dialogue and break these concepts down into all of this. And it was just
this complex
like,
diagram.
I wrote that. Those are basically the notes. Like I wrote all of these notes out and I just wrote them in stream of consciousness. And then I was going to go back through and actually like make the book super sophisticated. Mm. And everybody was like, don't just the way it
here's
comes
what you
off.
Should do. Yeah. Here's what you should not do.
Yeah.
Done.
It was just blog. Like there people compare it to a blog. They're like, dude, this sounds like just like you would talk right now. And
so
it works.
I'm overly excited because Christmas is right around the corner.
You can buy them for all your friends.
I feel like
yeah.
we're starting an SNL. Like skit or something.
Yeah.
She's like, this
my
is the craft.
My clients will get autographed because, no,
like
for
craft,
the men,
like books.
It's very direct and some people are not comfortable discussing this, but if they read it in their own leisure time and privacy.
Mm-hmm.
So in other words, slap a bow on that and give this to like your significant other who needs some fucking help.
Yeah, with some coloring pencils.
We've got a month. People
some coloring pencils.
Got a month.
I didn't even think of that.
I'm messing with your timetables. Order now, right?
I know. I kind of
get
it. All
right.
Are we
going to
get raw here? Are we going to get like.
Yeah,
fast?
So.
We're direct. We're bold here, Jared.
I'm like mini. I'm
okay,
scared.
Okay. You want to get real now. You want to get raw now. Okay.
I want to learn. Hold me, mini. Hold me.
We got to educate the public, right? We got to educate these people.
Yeah, so go over these stats. And so Mini, as a bipartisan who has no. She's. The only person here that's not in the dating industry, we're gonna test out Minnie's reactions
so far
to
away
Sandy's
from
facts.
Minnie. Yeah, I want to be closer to Minnie.
All right,
Minnie, why can't I be closer?
Don't block her with your microphone.
Oh, she's, I know she's so Minnie.
Don't do that. Turn it. There we go.
But I like her so much.
All right.
Okay, get back over there.
I'm over here.
You're still got a little ways to go.
Fine.
There you go.
So, what should we start with? Catfishing?
I love you still, Minnie.
Start with whatever you got. Okay. Just read the stats. Let's discuss them.
All right. So. Let's see, 51% of online dating people are already in a relationship.
This is true, you assholes.
I had no idea.
Well, time wasters, like really?
You're going to get caught. What are you doing?
It's an ego boost. It's a complete ego boost. So here I am, I'm investing on whatever website, $30 to $60 a month to meet somebody single.
Mm-hmm.
Or their relationship is on the rocks, and they're like, yeah. Oh, well, maybe it's time to look for somebody else to see if I should leave this person.
Yeah, yeah.
Because
yeah,
I met people like that.
It was on the rocks before they even met the person that they're in the relationship
Everybody
with.
Wants the best thing that they can get, and sometimes people take that way too far, and they're like, well, if I can't get anything better, I'm gonna stay with this person.
Backup.
But let
backup.
Me, let, yeah,
it's totally backup.
This is disgusting.
You put me on the back burner. You're
but, like, seriously, done. That's a waste of time. I'm it's sorry, bad. That's a part-time job. It
what do you think, Minnie?
I feel like a lot of people probably do it without even the intention of meeting up with the person, but just like, yeah, like the ego boost thing. I mean, because I'm an actor and a model, but I also was like in the adult industry for a while. So I feel like a lot of people do things like on the internet as like a way to, I don't know, have a different persona and kind of, you know, this person who has no idea who they are, what they are like in the context of their everyday life, you can kind of just fake whatever.
Or people are just damn dirty cheaters and they should be shot and killed. I don't know though, because then we've had shows on polygamy and polyamorous relationships and all of those different things, and it's like, well, is monogamy really is monogamy the right way and polygamy the wrong way? Is cheating and like, how does that whole thing work? But that's a topic for another show. Because that's still a big one. But yeah, so continue with the stats.
Okay, all right. And then we got, okay, this is freaky, man. Like, so, like I said, I'm all about educating my clients, right? 25% of rapists were estimated to utilize online dating sites.
Not what? Surprised. Where were you? Victim. I so you still got, swear I've been raped a billion times. I just haven't. Where I missed that one.
Like, that
I make fun
up.
Of it. I totally make fun
so
of it.
So that's a 1 in 4 chance? 25%?
Yeah, that's really frightening.
25%.
Really
25%.
So 1 in 4 of the men that you're meeting or the women that you're meeting. Wait. So was that just with men or women?
No. It's just generalized.
Watch your drinks.
Yeah.
Watch your drinks.
So I'm over here like, would somebody fucking date rape me, please? Like, I don't know.
See, that was where I went with it at first, and then I kind of scaled back because you all looked at me like I was crazy, and I'm like, I'm just kidding. Watch your drinks.
I'm like, free drugs, good night. But like, it
it's
depends.
Scary. What is the statistic of rape? Okay,
if you want the person to take control of the situation,
yeah,
that's
true.
Different.
That's true. Yeah. Right. I guess there are lots of people that I wouldn't want to say.
So just like 1 in 10 are sex offenders online, right? Because online, when you're online, you're behind a screen, right? You could betray whoever you want to be in order, you know, to get whatever type of feedback or ego boost that you're
looking
for.
Say that again. One in ten
are sex offenders. Right.
Ooh. Predators. Like, are we going like Dateline style, like hands in the cookie jar? I don't know why I'm here. She said she was.
Yeah. So think about
22,
it.
22. Like, she's 13.
The fake pictures, the fake profile. You don't know who wrote that. The neighbor,
you
your
don't.
Sister, your mama. But at the same time, here you're investing your time and your money, but you never meet. So I call that as a text ship. Do you classify that as text and ship?
Oh, a text ship.
What?
Text and ship.
Oh, I see.
A text ship.
Yeah, you never meet. It's
definitely not the friend zone, that's for sure.
That's just called catfishing.
Catfishing?
What, when you text and never meet.
Yeah, you classify it as catfishing? Okay.
I mean, when people, they consistently have an excuse as to never meet you.
Yeah.
That's what happens when you're getting catfished, because it's like, oh, hey, let's set up a date. Nope. Set up a date. Nope.
I'm not really 25 years old and look like Brad Pitt when he was 25.
They can't ever meet you for a reason.
All right. So move on. This is interesting. So we have all these online dating sites. You're registered. You pay for it, right? That's your money. That's your profile. That's your picture.
Got to pay to play.
I can't people pay that shit anymore.
You own that profile. Now, 80% of that is leaked to other dating services. To third parties. Mm-hmm. So that's how they're getting junk mail.
Threesome third parties.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's BS.
It's bad.
If I'm investing in an online company and I'm spending a certain amount of time and money, but then
if you're on Match.com, you're on JDate and all these other things, and I'm not even going to plug any of them until you assholes pay us for sponsorship, but I just did two of them, big ones.
Yeah.
So.
And then they're sharing your email and information. Like, that's some type of violation.
It is a violation. So how do we protect ourselves from that?
Our third our information is being sold to so many different third party, and it's totally done behind closed doors, behind the curtain. And, you know, that is an issue that will be addressed in the next decade, I think. But for right now, people are just starting to realize, they're like, oh, shit, like, why am I seeing all these awesome ads? And it's like, because they're cooking the sites that you and tracking pixels.
They're aggregating
and all stuff.
Your social media behavior.
I literally just found a website today that actually any site that you visit, it'll alert you to what cookies it's using and and the tracking pixels, and you can opt to get rid of them or keep them. It's pretty awesome.
That's
I forget
good.
What it's called.
It filters them out. I like that. So hooking up, 1 in 3. So 1 out of 3 women who meet somebody online have sex on the first date.
You got 30% chance, guys.
It's pretty good and slutty.
Yeah, yeah.
Is it slutty, though? And is slut shaming, like, yeah. I mean, well, how is, not it, at all. Is it wrong?
Not at all. I just wanted to say it because my mom's watching. So sorry, Mom, I'm not doing that. Yeah, totally. I'm actually. She's
okay, dead. Okay. So to get more deep, 8 of 10 people now from those dates don't use protection. While
yeah, that's
sex.
That's dirty. Questionable.
That is, yeah.
Yeah, it's a questionable. Unless cool you got part. Your like results like from the day before, well, like right there, or the day of.
So it's like me and you. This is a perfect example. We just met in the parking lot today.
Yeah, I just got tested like an hour before I met you, and so I've got my tests like right there. Like I forged them like on whatever it was .com.
Yeah. So then later
people
on,
people will do that. I bet. I don't know. But
so then later on, could. You know, we don't really know who we are.
It's
but
just
we,
not okay.
Yeah.
No
yeah,
matter what.
It's not right.
Unless you're in the doctor's office with
just
me.
Take a vodka shot right and stick to oral. I mean. Alcohol kills germs.
You mean are you taking a shot like?
Just take a vodka shot, stick to oral. Alcohol kills germs. I forget where I heard that from, but it made me laugh when I heard it.
That's you have a social responsibility.
I can't
to
own
tell
that. That was not
that
just me.
That's not yes. something you should do.
I don't care if you brush with hydrogen peroxide 8 times a day.
I take it back. Like, you didn't hear that on Modern Male Radio. You
yeah.
cannot.
Think about how you had to do the big font for the. Uh-huh. You have to. That was sorry. You know.
Oh, honestly, like
real.
I got I did so much like kind of being like, no, bad. Do it this way. Do it that way. That I actually was like, eh, fuck it. Maybe people will listen more if I start doing the bad stuff and kind of be like, we're just going to go over the top. So that's when me and Sarah actually started our reality show on bad dates. And we just embodied the worst kind of people that we've like met. And we just fuck around with all the stereotypes.
I go back to where I started from with this. People don't want to see who wore it right. Mm-hmm. We want to see whose nipples popped out. Okay, we do. So we want to see who made the mistakes.
Yeah, nobody. You know what? That's where I'll learn from. No one's perfect, right? And if you're portraying perfection, you're not being genuine.
If you're showing me butterflies and rainbows all the time. Fuck you.
Right. Well, and that's what I like with the show, right? We are all raw. We all just met each other in the parking lot, you know.
And that's how the book is as
well.
Equals
I have
it's,
problems
it's
and
pretty
I'm
raw.
Really okay sharing them. But
it's pretty,
true.
It's pretty
true.
Out there. Like, I definitely don't sugarcoat anything.
No, you didn't. So to continue on dating facts. So men.
Yeah, yeah.
Men. Number one, what they look for and a lovely lady is trust.
And a lovely lady might be trustworthy.
Trust,
a lovely one.
Then respect, then attraction, then humor, then sex.
I call bullshit on
I call
all of
bullshit.
That. Attraction
complete
should have been
bullshit.
Like way before any of the rest of the stuff.
Where did you get that stat?
Oh man, this is like from like 10 different websites when I did my research.
Okay, well that so website's full of shit.
Okay, so that's for men. Ladies, number one is respect, trust, humor, values, then social.
Where was the penis in any of that? And where were tits in the first of that?
Yeah, like, I was okay, the second she started naming those off, I was like, so the first three things that males find attractive.
Trust, respect,
attraction. A pretty face, big boobs, a big ass. And then they start looking for personality
traits.
Because
you're looking, and then you're looking. There's a stand there.
You know
trust
what? Most guys won't even
here.
Don't even care if she has a personality. He'll be like, just look, shut up, sit in the corner, look pretty. Yeah. I mean, and that's a male thing.
Can you trust the doctor that did that tit job? Yep, they look good.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's it, it and I would.
But I think this is generalized. It's not like.
I think that whatever that stat came from is complete bullshit.
But I don't. I think we're viewing it from an incorrect perspective, right? So we're viewing this general, not our first meet. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm looking for. Right. This is after a few
days. Like an actual partner.
Yeah, yeah. We connect like we're on third or fourth date, and then you start viewing like, is she trustworthy? Is she respectful?
I'm still like, I'm so attracted to you.
He's
like,
still looking
that's,
at the tits. He's still looking
and
at the face.
And I'm not saying that that's my opinion personally, but I mean, that's what I do. I work with guys, and that's I understand males and. That's how it is. That's how most guys think. And we're getting a little smarter.
Did that bitch gain 10 pounds in the first 2 months? Because done.
Most guys aren't super concerned with that. But I mean, it's more like, does she...
Yeah, if it went to the right places, of course not. Too.
Most men want to have and not need rather than need and not have. Yeah. So, I mean, it depends. Like, everybody likes different things. And so it's really hard to generalize everything in a whole. Because, I mean, I personally have dated girls that were like, that were opposite from each other. They were completely different. Both physically, mentally, emotionally, everything. You know, it's
trust
all about what you need at the time.
Trust and respect wise, too. One you could really trust, the other you couldn't.
So,
like, these
I never look for
so,
that.
Like,
and
general.
I also have a very interesting perspective on trust. I don't really believe in it so much. When people are like, oh, I trust you, I trust you, I trust you. For me, that's kind of an admission to your lack of taking care of things. for me to have to trust you, it means that there's something in my life that I'm not taking care of that I need you to do for me, or I need to lean on you in some way.
What even is that? Can I trust you to pick me up if I say, can you come get me? Trust you to
I tend to have all of my bells and whistles. Everything's locked. So it's like I don't need to trust anybody, because there's never a place where I'm going to like roll over and be vulnerable. I'm always developing. So that, and it's an interesting perspective on trust, because everybody's like, you trust me, bro? You trust me? And I'm like, no. And they're like, why? And I'm like, I don't have to. No. But I like you a lot.
Now, together, you're like, both of your experience and your insight. So on your first date, your first encounter, when you meet somebody.
Can I trust this person not to date rape my drink when I go pee and leave my drink?
Yeah, that's probably
a concern. No. Like, would you know, or would you feel you need to give him an opportunity? Like, would you feel if you know you need to, like, you can connect? Or not connect?
What?
That's actually like a really, really important question.
So the first time we meet, right? So say the first time we meet, would you know right then and there, are you going to give me an opportunity, or is it going to take 2-3 dates? Right?
I generally know immediately.
And I'm the same way.
Like,
but there have been exceptions to that, so I can't hardline that. There have been.
Yeah, I generally know like the first day.
Some people have really slid the fuck up super quick, and then I've gotten to know them.
So I'm going to disagree on that, because the first time you encounter somebody, I know when you first meet somebody, if you're attracted, like, oh, he's fine, he's not bad. But then when you have an engaging conversation, you could go.
Yeah, but women are like that. Men are not. Men are pretty much, we're right there. And if anything, it's like the opposite with men. You know, women can grow to love somebody. And you see that all the time where she's around this guy. He keeps on persistently kind of winning her over. And then he sabotages her emotional psyche, her emotional anchoring mechanisms. And he starts to create attraction. And that's an awesome thing for guys. That's why that whole, you know, keep persisting thing is so prevalent in the male community. You know, if you just keep hammering at it, you might get her.
But I find if you give someone the opportunity, like go on a few dates, you truly get to know them more and you become more appealing. Because as we
definitely
age, now romantically, or what kind of relationship are we talking
like
about?
Like, and also basically in intimacy and love, there's seven layers, right? There's seven types of love. But when you get to know somebody, like truly on the inside, because we're young, right? We all go for looks and, oh, he's hot. Oh, he's so cute. But as we age, we're not going to have...
You're going after value.
Yeah.
Right. So
unless you get Botox, then you're going for looks.
But and even that, I mean,
like, I'm going to stay like this forever.
Every three months. We can retain all we want, but, like, God forbid something happens. What really happens or makes you more desirable is what's in your heart.
Of course,
and that's
yeah.
What I'm gonna,
lust is not going to sustain.
Like,
you have to know,
Jeremy love me because he's like, oh, she's hot, she's sexy. That's Sandy. She's hot in bed.
Totally Sandy.
You know, I love that. I'm marking myself on that. Thanks, Jared. Anyways, he didn't even second me on that.
Not even a question.
You know, and as we age 20 years from now, and then, you know, I get sick and
you're
I'm on the bedside.
You're a little colder. You're not as hot.
Yeah, I'm not
colder.
As hot. I don't maintain myself. I gain 30 pounds.
Right.
And then he tosses me.
See, I'm adamant against that kind of stuff.
Lovingly,
and a lot of people, they don't go out of relationships because they don't think they can do any better, or they get lazy. I don't believe in getting lazy. I don't believe in letting yourself go. I think if one party's done that, then I think that the other person has you should be great. You should be your best self at all times and all respects, and you should be that for you. They should want to be there.
So Sandy, you better brush up on those push-ups when you're 75. Down,
but I'm just saying,
down,
like,
down.
You know, as we age, like, maybe can't go to the gym because, you know, there's health concerns.
Yeah,
now.
You're going to find another. You're going to find a home gym, Sandy.
No, he's something's happening. Like, you know what I mean?
Something's
like,
going to happen.
Yeah, but I mean, there's Pilates. Like, there's no
there's
excuse.
Something there.
Or I get sick. Like, I get cancer, right? So I'm on my bed.
Cancer!
I know.
That's different. And I think that the social indicators there of like cheating on your girl or breaking up with your girl when she gets cancer.
He's like, that's not cancer. It's like, stomach flu.
That's like worse than being like a sex offender or a child molester. Like, I mean, that's one of the, I've never even heard of that. Like, you can't do that.
Welcome to my life now, Minnie.
Oh my goodness.
It's been 2 years. I'm like, did I just
so,
say
yeah,
that?
So yeah,
stomach flu. I did.
I think that it's so like that. That's probably the worst. Like, can you name something worse than maybe like punting a kitten?
Aww.
Like,
what's with hitting a kitten? In the book, the whole metaphor, kitten,
she
cat,
actually,
dogs.
Women are cats, men are dogs.
Yeah,
it's such
it's
a simple
metaphor.
Example.
It's okay, kitten.
Yeah.
It's okay, kitten.
I like that. It's okay.
No, he actually is a huge like cat rescuer, so I don't know why the punting of the kitten.
Yeah, no. I had it. I used to work at a cat rescue when I was a kid. But I was saying like breaking up with your girl when she's got cancer would be like, I don't know. That would make you like the worst human being on the planet.
It's pretty bad.
Yeah, that's
horrible.
Really,
really bad.
mm-hmm. you know.
Mm-hmm. It would show your true colors.
So what do we got next on the stat list?
That's what it would do.
No, for sure. So like during your roughest time, like you know who's there, who's not, who's best going to support you. Most active sites for mobile dating, New York, London, L.A., and Hong Kong.
Hong Kong, huh?
Hong Kong.
How exciting.
Yeah.
All right, let's get through these because we got a few minutes left.
No. We're good. We're covered on that aspect.
Are we covered? Oh,
okay. Yeah, all my stats. Told you I was raw.
Damn.
You got them.
Just like,
it was rapid fire up in here.
Technical and tactical just under the covers. Yeah. Private and stuff. So, I feel like I learned. Yeah.
So what do you think about all this, Minnie? Does this affect your want to and desire to date in the world? Or you're not dating right now? Your boyfriend's right here.
Yeah. She's got a boyfriend. She's got a man.
Well, it's, I mean, I really never liked dating very much at all. Like, I feel like I'm a relationship kind of person. I don't know. The whole dating, like, I hear so many horror stories and I read so many things. I feel like I already, like, deal with so many random guys as is that I'm just like, I don't.
You're lucky. You're already past
But in order to obtain a relationship, you got to date, right? You got to explore.
True. But I didn't we didn't hit up Tinder and then we matched.
God, Minnie, you're so lucky. So lucky you didn't do that.
It just happened. Like what happened for me was kind of, I feel like he didn't pursue me. And that's kind of what was attractive to me because there is kind of that culture in the male thing to pursue this girl mm-hmm. and be persistent, and that's like very normal and even kind of good, which in my opinion it's not. And
yeah,
I don't like
and you see so much of that now the best way to hit on somebody is not to hit on them.
But
It's not even that because you can be polite about it and stuff, but
I'm an expert at this, okay?
And yet, who's got the man? Who's talking about the man? Sorry, but.
And so
I'm just messing with you.
It mm-hmm. wasn't even like, oh, ignore me, treat me like shit. It's not like that kind of thing at all. But it's more like this culture in males to be, and it's a socialized thing. It's not like a biology thing or anything like that. It's a socialized behavior thing where it tells men, persistence is a good thing. The fact that we even call it persistence as like it's you're persevering through something. If she said no.
Yeah, exactly.
If she didn't want it, like that's fine. It doesn't make you like better that you waited for 3 years for her. That like makes you kind of a fucking weirdo.
Or that you're pushy enough to just be like, why aren't you paying attention to me? Persistence.
Exactly. You're not thinking about what she wants.
But
really,
I will. I agree, but I disagree because if a male is not pursuing me or giving me attention in the beginning when we just first met, how do I know you're interested in me?
Oh, well, I'm not against you pursuing, but it's the persistent thing when you're like, no, I'm okay, and then taking that as like a challenge.
I think the best thing to remember is that it's not one size fits all. Yeah. And whether or not it's so different, one thing or another, it could completely change depending on the person.
Because
some people be like, oh, I like it. When this but guy I mean, there's definitely me. Like, I hate it when this guy comes at me.
I met girls who are like, oh, I love needy guys, and I'm like, what? Because that's most women's main complaint. And I've met girls who are like, oh, he persisted for like 3 years, and we finally were together, and I'm like, okay.
There are girls who love that,
But like that is very, very rare. And I will add here that my number one best tactic in the world is to treat a woman as though she were not a woman or something to conquer or sleep
with. Hallelujah.
Just treat her like a normal human being. Be around her. Yeah. Don't hit on her. And guess what? You'll probably do 1,000 times better. She's like, oh my God, this guy's really cool. Now you're the one guy that she gets to have positive male interaction with that she doesn't get to have with anybody else.
Yeah.
And then you can start portraying all of the masculine traits, the sexy things that, mm-hmm. women are attracted to. And you can start kind of timing those things.
You can take your shirt off.
That's a better way to be persistent. You can be persistent without begging her to take you or begging or standing there presenting yourself
you're
like,
gonna take
please
that.
Take
you're
me.
Gonna take
please,
this.
Please be mine. Yeah. It's like, and he might even see it as like even a masculine over dominating thing. Like, I'm going to get this girl. And it's like, no, you're not, man. You're literally like bludgeoning her into not wanting to fight anymore.
But I will admit, like in the beginning, it's all about you guys, right? Because you guys are more in control when you first meet us, right? Mm-hmm. Are you giving us attention? Are you respecting us? Are you treating us like a princess? Because
Are you doing all the things a guy should do?
Yeah, exactly. But you got to be genuine. And like, if you're getting a compliment.
Well, there's also different cultures because LA is very much its own culture.
Are you opening my door? Because if you're Australian, apparently you're fucking not.
Yeah. So.
seriously.
In LA, like the culture here is so much different than the rest of even our state. Yeah. I can't imagine what it's like in Canada versus here.
Well, it depends what area.
Maybe that's
Canada.
Why she's here.
Yeah. No, apparently. Like Toronto's a big city, just like LA, right?
It's like what Minnie was saying. It's cultural. There's so much culture there.
Yeah. And it's very diverse. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, majority of people are so focused now on their career. But at the same time, they've been burned in the past. So what I'm finding, a lot of people are either A, self-sabotaging themselves.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Which, oh my goodness, it's brutal. They come to me and then we have a 2-hour meeting and here they think I'm going to hook them up and I deny them. I'm like, nope, sorry, I can't take you as a client. You need to work on this, and then we'll go back to the drawing board. Because if that ready mentally and physically, I could give you the perfect person.
And you destroy it.
You'll mess it up.
It ain't going to
2.5 seconds.
It ain't going to work, right? So it's on the inside, but on the outside, right? You got to have confidence. You got to know what you want.
And you yelled at a lot?
No, I'm okay. Nah, they're like in shock.
She's like, I'm good.
It's okay. You know,
you yell at me, I'm just still going to be like, I'm good.
Yeah. But
Sandy, where can people find you?
Oh, my goodness.
We need to have people find you.
Yeah, what you need to do is have a back-end coaching program on that. But I'll teach you how to do that.
/ pilot, where we're definitely playing like Sandy's Angels. Private investigators under the covers for your dating needs and stuff.
Yeah. I'm Jared's little
just give me the handcuffs.
Grasshopper
follow you around.
What does that mean?
I'm a grasshopper.
Grasshopper. I love that name.
Oh.
I just
said
that too. I don't know.
That's like I'm Kung Fu, like Legend Continues.
Kung Fu fighting.
Yeah, okay.
No, but I was like, you don't look like a grasshopper.
You gotta say it with an accent. Oh, grasshopper.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, grasshopper.
I'm like, no.
You're pushing it there.
You said it. You're like, oh, I'm a little grasshopper, and I was like, what?
I was giving you a compliment. Oh, miscommunication.
I'm fucking with you.
It does happen. If I like social media, which I don't, but I'm going to pretend that I do for the sake of time, where can people find you on social media?
Okay, so on Facebook, it's Volt Connection, and they can follow me on there. And then Twitter, it's Sandy DePose. And then on the website, it's voltconnection.ca.
So Volt, like...
Volt. So
Volt.
Volt.
It's not like Deacon Dick, it's Volt.
Volt, V-O-L-T.
Like the car.
It took me 3 months to develop this name. And I developed it when I was at the gym doing abs.
You're like,
the Volt. V. I see Volt. The V. Volt.
No, because I know I found that name. It defined who I was. I'm very direct, but I thought the name was powerful, right? But it didn't sound like a club or a bar or a strip joint. It was very unique, but very bold.
What happened?
So the other names that you were coming up with sounded like strip clubs and
bars. Or like too girly, like, oh, sparkle, oh, dazzle. You know what I mean? So, yeah, that name took me 3 months to develop.
I like sparkle, personally.
I'm kind of into dazzle. Manny, where can people find you on social media?
I'm at Mini Scarlet on Instagram, Twitter. It's just MINNIE, like Mini, and then Scarlet with 1 T.
And that's that.
Cool.
Very
awesome.
Easy.
And you can be sure to catch Mini's web series.
Can you keep up?
Is it? That's what it's called?
Yes. You can also find us on Twitter. So it's CYKU, Can You Keep Up, official. And that's it.
Can you keep up?
And she's freaking hilarious. Like, legitimately laugh out loud funny.
Thank you.
Cool.
You're welcome.
And as always, you can find us at modernmailinc.com/radio. You can find us on Twitter at Mail Methodology. You can find us on Instagram at modern.mail. And you can find us online or on Facebook or wherever the fuck. Just Google Modern
Mail.
You can
find me running
down
the street
saying, "Fuck you,
Facebook,"
with SEO.
Right now.
So, yes. And if you guys are on YouTube, please subscribe. If you guys are not on YouTube, go on YouTube and subscribe.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. That's it for tonight, folks. Thanks for tuning in to Modern Mail Radio.
You're listening to Modern Mail Radio with Jared Zavistowski, right here on LA Talk Radio.